Man, what the heck? I can't make any sales. Just wanna hit something. Bro, it's all right. You're just in a sales slump. I'm a marketing entrepreneur and I've sold millions of dollars of product and I'm gonna give you 5 tips to get out of your sales slump. Everything's gonna be all right. Let's go over these 5 tips to get out of a sales slump and start making money again. Let's get it. Hey, John Cristani here, marketer and tech entrepreneur, and I've been there. You know, I do sales and marketing for a living. I've been there where you just wanna freaking hit something because you can't make a sale. You can't get a deal. You're marketing over and over, you're selling over and over, and your numbers are zero, or your numbers, maybe they're low, and you just can't make any money. Don't worry about it, because we all go through it. It's a cycle. What it is, a sales slump is this cycle where you don't make money, and then your confidence goes down, and then you get worse and worse and worse and worse, and you start doubting everything. Are you in a sales slump right now? Type in I am in the comments if you are, but it's a downward spiral because confidence helps sales and marketing and it just all gets worse. Now I'm gonna be talking about 5 tips to get out of sales and marketing slumps in this video. And these tips are right here. And the first is, as always, keep going. Now I train thousands of students. I teach tens of thousands of people to learn how to do commission-only sales and marketing. And the biggest reason that I see people completely fail, completely just lose money and time and opportunity costs and just fail, is because they stop, okay? It's because they stop. And you don't want to stop. The only way you can fail is if you stop. You have to keep going. And ultimately, you're doing this because you love doing this. You got into sales, you got into marketing because you enjoy doing it. You enjoy connecting with people. You enjoy advertising or doing whatever. You enjoy social media. And if you stop, you're letting your emotions get to you. If you stop, you're letting your head, you're letting your thinking brain take over and betray your heart. You already chose a direction. And the most successful entrepreneurs, they've been doing the same thing over and over for years. There was a piece of advice that one of my mentors gave me, and it was, the obstacle is the way. Let me say it again. The obstacle is the way. And if you're going through a slump, if there's some obstacles, maybe the market's changed, maybe there's new regulations, maybe you've just lost confidence in your tonality or your pitch or your enthusiasm or your authority on a subject is not being conveyed correctly. Or maybe you're putting up marketing posts, but you're not really analyzing your numbers. You're not actually looking at things. You're not actually trying to figure out why something things working or not, because you're frustrated and you're just sacrificing and creating activity but not and doing analysis, right? All of those things are not good. All of those things are bad ways of dealing with an obstacle. And if you just address and figure out and deal with the obstacle and figure out a way to get over it, you will be a much better salesperson, a much better marketer. The second tip I have for you is measure yourself. Measure yourself always. There's a famous quote from Peter Drucker, the father of modern management, which says, you can only manage what you measure. And if you aren't measuring yourself, you're not managing yourself. So let's go over this real quick. Now, anytime I go through a sales slump and I sell other people's products on the internet through a process called affiliate marketing, I go through slumps as well. My income varies. It goes anywhere from $200,000 a month to $900,000 a month. And you betcha that I get really annoyed when I'm making $500,000 or $900,000 a month in my business and our sales go down. If I'm used to making money up here at, let's say, 900K, and then I go all the way down to 200K, that hurts. That hurts. This is total revenue. When, you know, sometimes my business, it'll run in the negative. I'll be losing money. And the previous month, I would have made $250,000 profit. So that hurts, and it really affects my entire mentality. And what I start doing when that happens is I do something that's very easy. I start measuring myself. And what I do is I create create a chart, okay? There's a sheet on Google Drive that I use, and I just measure what I do each day. I say time started, okay? I measure the time I start an activity. Let's say I start an activity at 9:10, and then I do the time ended. And I measure everything I do throughout the day. So I'll put up an activity. Let's say my activity is posting on socials, doing posting on social media. I will measure my time doing that. And if I lose focus for even a second, let's say I go to get a cup of water, or let's say I start reading through other people's Facebook posts, right? Or let's say, you know, my dog starts barking, I stop and I say, okay, I just ended that activity at 9:15. And then I'll have to do another item where I'll say I'm posting, right? And I'll start it again at 9:20. And I'll measure how long I work on that activity till maybe 9:45. But I measure what I do throughout the entire day, no matter what. And what I found was that oftentimes, much of my day is spent doing non-revenue generating activities. And how I've been able to account for that is I'll put an asterisk next to each item at the end of the day that was useful time for creating sales. And what I found is that when I'm going through slumps, when I begin the slump, I am spending an inordinate amount of time mucking around. Maybe I'm making coffee, or maybe I spend extra time at lunch, or maybe I spend time reading through social media or reading the news or doing stuff. Anything besides actually selling, anything besides actually posting links, which is what marketing is. It's posting links, or in sales, it's picking up the phone or knocking on doors, right? The more you measure yourself, and my advice here would be create more output, create more time where you're selling or you're marketing. Get your days so that you get out of the non-revenue generating activities so you can spend more time with your family. Now, the third tip I have for getting out of sales slumps is actually education. Learn more. If you are a smarter, more knowledgeable person, if you invest in yourself to become better, you're gonna give yourself a better chance of getting out of a sales slump. The more you learn, the more you earn. Now, I personally spend 2 to 3 hours every day learning something new. I spend a lot of time learning from people who are much more successful than me, because ultimately I'm looking for wealth. And to learn how to make more money, I need to spend time learning from people who are wealthier than me. And I actually am an educator myself. This I'm teaching here, but I actually have a training course, a 6-week training course, where I teach paid advertising and affiliate marketing, which is a way that you can create your own marketing business, marketing other companies, and get paid hundreds of thousands of dollars. There's really no cap. It's a commission-based position, and the power of the internet gives you monster leverage. So if you want to learn more about how to do marketing and stuff, you can learn from me, but there's many other courses that you can go through from people who are successful in sales and marketing, Tai Lopez, Grant Cardone, Tony Robbins, etc., where you can learn a lot. I spend a lot of time learning, and the more I learn, the more confident I get, and I've also found that confidence is very highly correlated with being successful. So enough about that. The fourth tip I have for getting out of sales slumps is, oddly enough, focusing on your health. Now, I just mentioned to you that confidence is a very important factor of being successful. And I found that getting your health in order, getting in good shape, getting that energy flowing, there's so many benefits of being healthy. Not just looking at yourself and looking in the mirror each day and saying, darn, I look pretty freaking good. But the benefits beyond that include stuff like you breathe better, your lungs have more capacity, you get more oxygen to your brain, literally oxygen. And what you feed your body, fats, amount of fats you put in your body, fats are good. If you eat healthy fats, they're brain food. If you focus on your health, you keep your machine oiled, you're gonna think better, you're gonna have more energy, you're gonna be able to attack problems better. You're not gonna get that brain fog. How many of you have ever gotten brain fog, by the way, where you're trying to focus, you're trying to think, you're trying to overcome an obstacle, but your brain just doesn't want to seem to work. It just says there's too many things, there's too many variables, there's too much stuff to hold in it at one time, and you just are kind of like, I just want to watch TV or something else. Let me know, just type in brain fog in the comments below if that's something that happens to you, because it used to happen to me all the time, and it still happens to me. But fortunately, I've really focused on my health. I got on the keto diet 2 months ago, actually. I lost 15 pounds. I used to have a little bit more of a belly here. So I've been losing weight. And I also got on a really cool new supplement that's just taken my muscle growth and my build, everything to a new level. I'm feeling pretty young. It's awesome. So definitely focusing on health is a great way to get your confidence up, get you back in the sales position. Doing sports is a great way of just interaction, of bringing yourself energy, of winning and getting those small wins, whether it's on the basketball court or the field, soccer field, is a way to enliven yourself and start going after and actually getting those deals and conveying that you are an authority on whatever subject you're marketing or speaking about. Tip number five for getting out of sales slumps is make it easier, okay? Now, a lot of people complicate things. There's every sort of way you can complicate things. I teach tens of thousands of people marketing, and people say, oh, I have to do this before I do that, and then I'll do C, and then I gotta put up a webpage, and then I gotta do this. Screw all of this, okay? If you are having a hard time making sales, boil it down to basics. You don't have to buy inventory and set up a business license and find a technical partner and all this stuff. Okay, if you're selling a product, just focus on the easiest thing. And if you're in just regular sales, instead of doing, you know, prospecting, you know, generally commission-only salespeople are doing prospecting, they're setting up meetings, which we call setting, and then they are closing. Generally doing sales, you're doing three things. In marketing, we're doing a number of other things. We're doing targeting and messaging and, you know, marketing. But you can make it easier on yourself. Instead of focusing on prospecting, setting, and closing deals, maybe you just remove one part of the pie. And you say, instead of closing deals, you're just going to start setting up conversations for other closers. Take a lower commission for yourself and let the closer get the rest of the commission. So you can back up and just start doing one part of the process, right? Make it easier for yourself. If you're marketing a very expensive product online, market a cheaper product, right? If you're trying to focus on a niche that, you know, is difficult to market, focus on a niche that is easy to market or easy to sell. If you're trying to sell a really complex, expensive product over the phone, focus on selling a little less complex, a little less expensive product. Just make the situation easier for yourself so you can get those small wins and then ultimately focus on getting back into those big wins, those big deals, whatever that is. I hope you learned something from this, but if you take away anything from this, just keep going. Stay focused. The obstacle is the way. The more you learn, the more you earn. Ultimately, to get out of a sales slump, it all depends on you. You need to become a better person. You need to become a better version of yourself. And the more time you spend growing, the better off you'll be. Likely, this sales slump is because you didn't focus enough on personal growth. Likely, the sales slump is because you just got lazy and lax and allowed sales to come in and didn't realize that the markets change, the job situations change, industries change, your competitors change, everything changes around you. So if you're not growing, you're losing. And you have to embrace that the new way of doing business is you can't rest on your laurels anymore. You have to constantly be investing in your own personal growth. If you're looking to learn more about marketing and a little bit about sales, make sure you subscribe to my channel and like this video if you enjoyed what I'm talking about. If you're interested in going deeper and actually getting into a big training course, I have a 6-week training course where I teach, really, it's mostly prospecting, which is, you know, just paid advertising to get leads, to get sales, okay? That's what I teach in my training course, and also how to do affiliate marketing, which is what I do for a living. Also, if you're looking to join a community and talk with people about these issues, make sure you join my Discord channel. We have a chat channel if you want to chat with people in real time. We also have a subreddit, so you can go on Reddit, and we have a link down to our Reddit community, and we also have a Facebook group where you can interact with other people on different topics. I want to bring everybody together. I want to make this the number one marketing community in the entire internet and help people succeed and make more money. So if you know this is the number one money channel on YouTube, type in number one money channel on YouTube right down below, and look forward to seeing you in future videos. Talk soon.